MrExcel podcast, sponsored by EasyExcel. Learn Excel from MrExcel podcast, episode 1556. Most popular function number 6, average. Hey, welcome back to the MrExcel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. In our series of most popular functions, and by the way, I'm not going in order. I'm going to skip around. We talked about sum last time. This time I want to talk about average, number 6 on the popularity list. So average, we'll get the mean, the arithmetic mean. And of course, you know, the quick way to get the average, if you just need to know what the average is select the cells and it will generally appear down here in the status bar. Now, if you're in Excel 2003, all you see is the sum, but you can right click and choose average. In Excel 2007 or 2010, you can show any of the 6 statistics. In 2003, it's just 1, but you can easily switch to average. All right, so to get an average, of course, that function is equal average, open parenthesis, and you specify the area. But I'm not going to do that because the AutoSum button, have you noticed it's actually a little drop down here? And if you open that drop down, you can choose average from the list and press enter. It works just like the AutoSum. And this is both here on the formula tab or back on the home tab. There's a drop down there that lets you choose average. So a quick way to put that formula in. Now, one funny thing about average is it only works with numeric values. So true and false, which I generally consider to be 1 and 0, those get thrown out by the average. So what we have here is the sum of these, and Excel is throwing out all 5 of them and then dividing by the count, and Excel is throwing out all 5 of them. You get 0 divided by 0, which is giving us the division by 0 error. But it is possible to average the series of dates. So here I have a series of dates. We have the average function. If I just format this as a long date, looks like we're having our company picnic on Thursday, July 9th, day out of work. Hoorah! All right. And then another cool function here, of course, alt equals will put in the sum function, right? If you need to put the average right below the sum, and a beautiful thing to do right here is to do control apostrophe. That gives us the exact same formula from above. Notice that the range did not move. It stayed at B2 to B6, even though there's not dollar signs. All right, so that's, I call that control ditto, because that apostrophe is on the same key as the little ditto mark that you might have used back in school to say, hey, the same thing as above. Now, once we're here, we have to press F2 to put it in edit mode, then home, right, delete, 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 and then we can start to type average. And we are good to go. A quick way to average the exact same range as above. But hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast, Mr. Excel.